stand and have a pledge and a prayer.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Jason, go ahead and pray.
Please bow. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and thank you for giving us traveling mercies here, Lord. We pray that you give us wisdom and help us make the right decisions for the community. Thank you for the good turnout today. Thank you for the soldiers that are fighting to keep us and give us the freedom that we have in order to come here today. Give us traveling mercy home, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you. All right, first order of business is approve the minutes from the previous meeting. Is there a motion on that? By Jackie, second by John. Any discussion?
You did both, right? The October 5th and the 19th.
Oh, yeah, special meeting as well. Yes. Any discussion? Seeing none, proceed to vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Motion carries. First item of business. We're going to do the main burn tax. Call it in.
That was the table.
But if it's on the table, we're going to take it off.
That's true.
All right. This is concerning, where is, if you got that thing that we tabled, Jennifer?
The amount on that may not be what you all choose.
Do you have a microphone on desk?
Pardon?
So what it needs.
That amount may not be accurate.
Well, it's not going to be large.
Well.
Okay. This is ordinance for a resolution for appropriations and tax rates. Main Huron Fire District, be it ordained that for the year ending December 31st, 2016, sums are hereby specified, hereby appropriated order, and order set apart at several funds herein for the Main Huron Fire District. If anybody wants to read a copy of this, you're welcome to do so. We tabled this at our October the 19th meeting because we felt like at that time that the amount asked for, which I believe was $449,000, was excessive. And we, I know that Councilman Britton, Councilperson Carter, and Councilman McCullough has met with the Van Buren Fire Chief and tried to work out a different budget. And I don't know who put this together. The fire department put together.
Todd.
So the budget that they are currently asking for is $209,300. Would anybody like to discuss this before we go into more detail?
Just for further explanation, the $209,300 figure comes from the $449,300 minus the full-time staffing. We had a special meeting last week with Todd and Walt, and they came up with a revised budget of $310,000. It still had $154,000 worth of staffing involved in that. And what we've come up with, if you take the $310,000 minus the $154,000, it comes up to $190,000. Basically, they'll still be operating as a volunteer fire department, but have a budget of $190,000. The voice that I've heard is that's the way the people want it. Whether that's from false information through the paper or whatever, that's the opinion that I've got over the phone and personal meeting with people. So, $190,000 is where we're at.
Okay. Is there any?
I was just going to say that I think
yeah, you got fuel at 16,000. I talked to another volunteer, and Brazil City's fuel is 6,000 for the whole year. And then most of the other volunteers are around 2,500, so 16,000 seems...
We run 9 trucks in 35 square miles, you know, 200 runs a year. Best I could do was, you know, kind of figure it out, and that's where we come up.
Tony, I don't want to interfere here, but if we approve the budget and their fuel is a little inflated, my concern is that the 190, they're not going to have the money to train the people they need to and get their equipment up to. They've been putting the equipment as far as certification and stuff like that. When they can afford it, they do it. And if he's got a little bit of an inflation in there for fuel, maybe that extra money can be used for the training. That's...
Well, I know they upped their training to 25,000 from 15,000. Did you notice that in the new
budget? On the last budget, right.
I have a question.
Go ahead. Can you tell us your name, please?
Is our budget designated?
Could you tell us your name, please?
My name's Beverly Carr.
Okay. And now, what's your question?
I'm sorry. I've never been to one of these.
That's okay.
Is our budget designated to a certain area by the state auditor, or is it flexible that they can go?
We set the budget.
From line item to line item?
They determine the budget. We set the budget, and they determine where the money is due.
But can they transfer from one area to another if they got to...
Are they allowed to do that?
Yes. Yeah, they can transfer.
Okay, so if they had an extra person on staff, then all of this extra could be used for a staff member as well.
Okay. So I guess it would be how they see
it. It could be. If there was enough, it could be. But in that budget, that's not possible. But I see what you're saying. Yes, we can move line items around.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm not sure the state auditor would like that.
Well, you know, the thing of it is, when they get the budget, they may not approve what they have here anyway.
That's true.
And, you know, and so all we do is we present it to them and say, we've approved this amount, and then they go through it and they actually determine what the tax rate is and so forth and so on. So
I know that municipalities have to stay within their budget for certain items, mm-hmm. and line items can't move from that particular thing to be paid, such as staff, fuel, supplies, training, and so forth.
There are certain things that can transfer to other things. There are certain things that can't. And as far as municipal budgets like that, I'm not as familiar with them as county budgets, but I know in county budgets, for example, if it's in personnel, it can't go to...
It stays in personnel.
Yes. It cannot go to, for example, fuel.
Right.
You know, it would not be...
Or training.
Yeah, if it goes to another category, then it has to come to us.
Such as training.
Yeah. If it goes from personal services to supplies,
right.
In other words, it has to go through us at the county level.
Does it have to be re-approved?
Well, in
the
county's budgets, but now Beverly on the municipals, I don't know how those work.
Yeah, not through ours.
I'm assuming that's the same, but I don't know for a fact because I don't sit on the municipal board. But Janice, are you, yeah, if you move something within a category from line to line, you don't have to do anything special. But if you go to a separate category, then you have to take it before your board, right?
I'd like to ask a question too. If this is such a great thing for the fire department, why is there not more firemen here than two people that's on the board or whatever? If I were the head of that, I would not be very happy. If they were all wanting the same thing, then they should all be here.
We asked our members not to come because if we showed up with 12 members, we didn't want to feel like we were intimidating anyone. So Todd and myself are the leaders of the department, so we decided to come ourselves instead of having all the members up. It just looks more professional than just have two of us here and have a little party.
I will say this, I mean, compared to what they originally asked for, or what we're talking about tonight, there's a significant reduction from what you were concerned about, yes.
I'm sorry, I don't want to be adversarial, but I was a dispatcher and for many years at Clay County. And one of the incidents that I remember, and probably Sheriff remembers, was the fire that we had at I-70, the motel. Okay, this is a good community and people volunteer one for another. If Brazil needs them, they go. We even had people from Sealyville wanting to offer air tanks if it's a huge emergency, which I don't see in Harmony, Carbon, and Knightsville. We have someone to answer the phone, we have a county dispatcher. We have, if we can't have volunteers, if we want two permanent people at the station, how many fires, structure fires or whatever, have we had? We live close to the fire department. We've worked for him, Bob has. He's been a marshal. He's been at the water company. We have not seen that many call-outs. We have not heard. Has anybody in here heard four of them a week? Have you heard one a week? And how much is this going to cost the people who can't afford it? If we're on Medicaid or Medicare, you cannot afford another $300 a year.
We're not even talking close to that at this point.
I know. But still, is it really necessary? And I know we need good fire protection. Our insurance won't go down. We've already looked into that personally. So I'm wondering, if you have a job for $30,000 that I can sit at the fire station and answer the phone, because it takes more than two people to get a fire truck out and, you know, and use the hose, or even hook it up to a water main. And we do take care of the water in Knoxville and Harmony. So we know those fire plugs work, but they're not being used. The last time they had a fire in Knoxville, they backed the tanker up. And they didn't even use the open fire plug that we had prepared for them when they got there. So, as far as I'm concerned, personally, I think the core issue is we don't need it. And I think you should ask these people here whether they want it or not, if that's possible.
The one thing that has already happened, there has been enough people who petitioned for them to get a fire district.
You know what?
It's already being established. We're not in charge of that. That's not what we do.
I signed that. But on seeing what the budget's going to be, my neighbor can't afford that.
I mean, we are reducing it dramatically.
Beverly.
Dramatically.
Yes.
Tony and Larry was on. We had a conference call. Thank you. With the Department of Local Government Finance a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
And the lady that told us that on the $449,000 budget, property taxes on a $100,000 home would go up $140.
That's if you got all your exemptions.
After exemptions.
Homestead,
right.
Mortgage.
Now,
$140 a year
after all exemptions.
Yeah. If you have a mortgage exemption and a homestead exemption. Okay.
So that means some people would pay more than others.
Well, yeah, that's going to be the case no matter what it's said. But if we cut it down to 190 or whatever, based on percentages I'm kind of going through, it looks like it's going to be more like around $60 a year on a $100,000 home.
That's per year.
Per year, yeah. The first year. The second year will be less because the first year, the district is funded completely with property tax money. The second year, 35% of it is funded with what's called Cadet Certified Shares.
I understand that.
Which is county income tax. So the second year, the property tax amount will drop down. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't have the exact numbers.
I have one more thing to say, and then I'll shut up. I hope. If we have people who inflate to an extent three times above what they really need to run that, are they trustworthy?
Those are decisions we cannot make, just to be honest with you. I mean, those are,
I know, but
those
we
are township decisions. All we have a budget, we have to either approve.
We are the people here that are going to
problem.
And we do want our community run on an honest basis.
Yeah, and part of the problem that I have, everybody else that can speak for themselves, is I don't know what it costs to run a fire department because I've never been on one. It's difficult for me to go through these numbers and say, that's too much.
If you have, which we don't need, if you have a job opening for two men for $30,000 a year, I'm not a man, but I'd volunteer and take that.
Well, we've eliminated those.
Those have already been eliminated, so that's not even.
Yeah, we've eliminated all the full-time positions.
Is there anyone else that would have served back in the court? Can you please give your name?
I'm new in your town. I've only been here 5 years. And I apologize, I'm deaf. I didn't put my hearing aids on because they usually have speakers and a helmet. So I come unprepared. I do have some questions. I can't hear what's going on too well. And this good gentleman beside me trying to clue me in. First of all, I see no high fire hydrants. Number one, there's none in town. I was told when I moved in here by my realtor that we had a dynamite fire department. I found it today. We got two fire trucks. I got a big home.
Where do you live, sir?
I have no, there's no fire hydrant. You're not going to put it out with those two trucks. Are you?
I don't know what you're talking about. Two trucks, sir. We have nine.
If you get a big house, I've fought them before. It takes a while.
They have nine trucks.
Okay. You have number five and number eight. That was my next question. Where are the rest of them?
We have two stations, sir. We have a station in Carbon and a station in Harmony. And we have more apparatus than any other volunteer fire department in the county.
I heard the lady asked a question. It's a good one. How many fires did you have last year?
Approximately 25.
25, we're going to have seven men?
No, that's
full
no.
Wages? No. To fight 25 fires a year?
That's
and you got two fire departments? You got seven men.
I don't think you understand, sir. We got seven in the beginning was total, and that's off the table. We've axed all that.
Those seven men that total. You don't pay it.
They're done.
They're out.
I'm just asking questions. I'm trying to put myself in. Eventually, you're going to have seven men and 35.
No.
They don't exist.
Well, how are you going to fight the fires?
Volunteers.
Same way they fight them now.
For what?
Volunteers.
I got three volunteer stickers. You know what I mean? Question. You got 25 fires, and you're asking $500,000. You're not?
No. It's down.
That's down to two?
Down to 209.
What the hell do I do there? I'll bring my hearing aid next time, but tonight you're going to have to speak a little louder.
My wife tells me I'm too loud all the time now.
I was just going to say, my thought process was we talked to Lewis, and Lewis, the first year of their district, they tripled their budget, and they started out with a $20,000 budget. Granted, it's a lot smaller than what this area is, but you guys have been running on a $60,000 budget, and my thought process, you know, even if we triple it, I think that's being more than generous, and that would give them $180,000.
Did everybody triple it this year?
We only have two. This is only our second district.
We only have two districts, John.
Lewis is the only other one we have. Really, that's true. But we just done Lewis.
Yeah,
it's
like three years old.
They tripled theirs this year.
Well, tripled the beginning.
2 years ago they did.
When it first started, and it's been slowly.
Yeah, that's misinformation.
Because I feel like that would at least get people used to what's going on and kind of like baby steps versus jumping all in with a big number.
The other thing I looked at, if you take Lewis Township, and I'm just playing devil's advocate here, they've got 1,800 per capita people. If you take their budget and divide it out, that's like $41.60 per capita. If you multiply that by the 8,200 people that's in Van Buren Township, you come up with $341,000. So
looking at it from a per capita standpoint, that 190 is still under the per capita what compared to Lewis. That's kind of the other thing I was looking at.
One of the things that I think, you know, Van Buren Township is one of the reasons why that Jason and Tony and Mike were the ones that kind of negotiated, because they know the area better than I do. And, you know, it's your district, and folks, I want, you know, I want you what you want. I will say this, volunteer fire departments, and I live in Clay City, and they have the same problem. They're having trouble finding new volunteers. And one of the reasons they have trouble finding new volunteers is because of the training costs they have to pay out of their own pocket can be $2,500 to $5,000 a year. And if you think about it, if you're going to volunteer for something that's going to cost you that much to volunteer, do you really want to volunteer? It's a lot of money. And so we're asking a lot of volunteers. And one of the things that we've been trying to address through fire districts is that they do have the funding to be able to pay those costs associated with training, so you don't have to make volunteers pay for volunteering. I mean, to me, that is common sense. I mean, I don't think anybody here would ask your neighbor to pay that much money out of their pocket just so they can volunteer. And so, you know, we don't unfortunately live in a perfect world, and there's nobody on here that likes high taxes less than I do, but on the other hand, I do think that they have a funding situation that does need to be addressed, not to the level that was originally at, and I think there's been some compromises worked out here. I think it makes sense to me. And is there anybody else that would like to comment about it before we make a decision on this?
Is there anybody in the audience that's totally against the fire district? I mean, the whole purpose of the fire district is for them to generate additional funds. So we're just trying to make you all happy and make them somewhat. I guarantee you, they're not happy when they leave here tonight. But we're trying to make them somewhat happy so they can feel like they can operate a little better.
We're just trying to protect you. That's all we're doing.
And we're caught in the middle trying to make everybody happy. Somebody raised their hand back there.
Back in the back row, back here.
And I interrupted them. I'm sorry.
Mr. Ryan.
Well, I think that they shouldn't have any additional fire department, you know, I mean, where they pay them. Just like the Medicare, I mean, they're not even getting raised this year. So, and then here they are wanting to take and have a pay additional people for fires when people want Medicare and not even getting a raise.
Well, let's make this perfectly clear. There is no full-time employees. We do not have any full-time. We took those out. They're gone. So there will not be any full-time employees in this budget. Training expenses and per diems possibly is the only thing for meetings and different things. And I don't even know if they're doing that for sure. So that's definitely off the table. Anybody else have any?
This can be changed, right?
It can be changed. Down the road, I mean, down the road, you know, we were originally told that they could not ever ask for an increase. That is not so. We've been told otherwise that they can. So, but at this point, this is what, you know, the rate will be established, and from that going forward, it's just like all the other tax rates, it will be established, and that's what it will be going forward until it's altered by an act of this council. Anybody else?
I've heard two different numbers here. One, 209, 300.
We haven't made a motion yet. I'm going to ask for a motion, though, on this.
I'm going to make a motion of a budget of
$190,000. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mike, a second. Is there any further discussion? Seeing none, proceed to vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed?
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you for your comments. I know you can't make everybody happy, but I think it was a good compromise early. Yeah. So, and I think that you'll.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think that everyone's
Larry, don't sign that. I need to change something on it, so we'll just wait till after the meeting.
Well, you don't want to sign it.
We have to set the law.
Okay, all right, all right.
We'll do that after the meeting. That's all I said.
That's all right.
Count the drive the wrong way down I-74.
Eyes are on the right side. So, what?
there any transfers?
Transfer where has been shown that additional existing appropriations now have unobligated balances which will not be needed for the purpose for which appropriated and is therefore ordained by the aforesaid county council that such unnecessary existing appropriations are now reduced and the money transfers to the necessary and proper appropriations in the amounts as follows. County Riverboat from workers' comp $17,400 to insurance $32,400. $32,400 for a total of, so it's going to make the insurance amount $38,664.
I have a typo on there. It should be the $38,664.25.
This doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Typo. Get rid of
it. It needs to be $17,400 on both, right?
It's just one line item.
Well, you're transferring. How much are you transferring?
38. That 17400, that is the account number.
I see. And then so is the insurance account number 32-4? Hold on.
What is this? I didn't get this.
Transferring $38,664.21.
Every year you all appropriate $80,000 for the workers' comp. Okay, so this year the workers' comp only went up a little bit, not as much as we were expecting, so we had leftover in Riverboat, but the general liability policy for all the buildings for here, the highway, the airport, everything, and it's split out by percentages. And the county's portion is 89%, the highways was 5%, and the airport was 6%. And there was not enough money in the line item for insurance, so we last year, the last 2 years, this is what they've done. They've taken anything left over from Riverboat, transferred it down to the insurance, and then paid it from there.
So we're transferring Riverboat money that was budgeted.
Yes.
So the operating balance of Riverboat is still there.
It was correct. Budgeted to workers' comp, but now we're changing it over
to a different line.
Remember, we used some of that operating balance for next year.
Yes, right. No, I didn't touch that.
Okay.
All right.
No, I remember
yes,
that.
Yes, the county does get paid a lot of insurance, so it's $38,664 just additional.
That's only a...
Yes, not this much of it. So. All right, is there a motion on this transfer?
I'll make a motion.
Mike?
Second.
Second by Tony. Any further discussion? Seeing none, proceed to vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, motion carries. That's on the left side. That's on the right side. This one's going to be on the left side. Okay.
Yes, the state changed the form.
Sheriff Harden requests order vehicles 2016. Okay, Sheriff?
Yes. In the past several years, the Sheriff's Office has requested three vehicles. I'd like to request three again. This way it keeps our fleet so that we're not replacing too many vehicles in one time. Remember, we turned in for our budget. You told us it was in the wrong line item because we tried to follow the budget from the year before. And so I'm back now to ask if we can get the funds to purchase three vehicles. We're in the process of trying to get the new bids or new quotes from the companies for 2016.
Did we eliminate all of his vehicles from it?
I thought we did that because they bought some new trucks.
Yeah, when did you get those trucks?
They were purchased in...
May.
Right, those were purchased out of forfeiture fund to replace two vehicles that were pretty high mileage.
So you got three new trucks when you did that, right?
No, we got two. We purchased two.
I did call DLG, or State Board of Accounts, because I was asking about that misdemeanor fund, and they indicated that that fund is no longer going to be, as of July, it was cut out. So I said, well, can you buy cars? And she says, well, kind of, it really wasn't straight. And she even called me back, but she said that they weren't, you know, they know people are using that misdemeanor fund up to get rid of it, so
okay.
They weren't going to be real strict about everything. So I
But they're doing away with it.
They're doing away with it. As of July of 2015, it's done.
15 or 16?
15. She said it's done.
Oh, I mean, they're not placing any more in it?
No.
Okay. So whenever we use it up, it's gone?
Yeah. I knew there was enough in there for a car. Talk to Josh a little bit about that.
Yeah. I want to say there's like 19,000 in there, so not quite enough for a car. I don't know.
I don't
think it's about 19,000, I'm not mistaken. Maybe a little more. I don't know if anything else has been increased in there. Generally, that does number better than me.
I can get them.
What?
I said I can get them.
You're asking for three cars? What kind of mileage are we talking about on the ones you want to replace?
One of them right now has 104,000, I believe, and two others are right under 100,000.
So by next year, they will be over.
And the reason we're asking now is to get in on the early, you know, to get it ordered early so that we can get it shortly after the first of the year. And I know that Mary Brown came in late in the year to get one for community corrections, and they put her off and said you have to get on the 2016 list because they won't make any more than 15s. So.
How much money are you asking?
In the past, we've always asked for $110,000, and that'll cover three vehicles to equip them also.
That seemed awful high. Weren't we paying like 23 or something for them?
Well, that's what you said to equip them. They went up, in 2016 they went up, but that's to equip them when you get them. So.
Putting all the lights and stuff.
Yeah, I know.
That'd be garage ready.
Yes.
So we're basically, I'm assuming, talking about taking this money if we do it out of ICE money. Be out of general fund, but
out of their eyes.
I mean, I think that we should. Jennifer's tracking that now. If we're going to do this, I think we should track that into the ICE money, so that it doesn't hurt our general fund balance.
We're getting there. By December, I'll have the year for you.
Have you already kind of got some idea?
I had to put somebody else in the office working on that because I had some other budget issues. So I've not seen it this week, but I know that they were making headway, and they were working with Anthony in the jail to get the fuel, working on that, and then trying to do our best to guesstimate the food and the other expenses prorated as best we could. So I'll have them work on that a little bit more diligently this rest of this week, and then I'll email it out to you.
So you have a total for 2015.
So what do you need from us, Paul? Because really we have to do this as an additional 2016.
Correct.
So we really can't approve it.
Right.
What's everybody's, I guess, opinion on that at this point?
I'd like to table. I think we should table
it
for another month until we get the ICE numbers.
I'd like to see we've spent how much out of there? The software and the dogs. Well, how much was the software? 290 or?
287.
No, but you're getting a grant for some of that, aren't you? What was that much?
We got a grant for $35,000.
Yeah.
And I just had our kickoff meeting today. There's a lot of software equipment that we made the expenditure, the quote, high end, where worst case scenario, yeah, for approval purposes. But we're looking at possibly saving a lot of hardware and stuff that Scott already has implemented in place. So this one, we may save more money than the $35,000, but minimum $35,000 less, so $250,000.
Yeah. maybe less.
Maybe less, but don't want to plan on that, just, you know.
The dog's 14 a piece.
28. Well, you know, I can remember, even I remember 6-8 years ago, when we really got, had a bunch of old cars and they started costing us quite a bit. We started trying to rotate them then.
We've been rotating for several years. At least two a year.
That's really don't have a problem with it.
And that's one of the things we're finding with Chargers, as they start getting higher mileage with the gravel on the roads. They sit so low, they're taking a pounding. When they get up to the 80,000, 90,000, we're seeing a lot of maintenance.
Are you going to trucks then, or are you going to keep the Chargers?
Yeah, we were looking at getting.
We're looking at replacing three of them with trucks this time.
So you'll have five trucks?
Yes.
How old are the three cars you're replacing?
2011.
They're not holding up as well as the Crown Vicks did, probably.
Yeah, they are.
Well, I mean, it's kind of like you said, you get that, as you hit a certain mileage, they go out, but they sit so low, you get a lot of front end damage. We just had one, and we had to replace the suspension in the whole front end. One is over in Terre Haute with a transmission, and it's got 60,000 miles, so it's even less, but we're starting to see some of that wear and tear, which is just, you know, common with those low-sitting cars.
I'll tell you, I'll always be for trucks when it's down there. Where I see one go by my house today going south, just where, as I was coming here. Mm-hmm. But when, if you own farmland and stuff like that down there, those guys can go right off the highway and drive across the field where whatever's happening is happening. But you can't do that with a car.
And the luxury.
And they drive as good as a car.
Your intent is not to go total truck fleet, is it?
No, not right now.
You're going to have some cars and
right.
mix.
Right.
But the luxury is even with the price. The trucks themselves really only cost $1,000 more than the car car. So you can just kind of take the trip, the resale value alone.
Well, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're
going to
hold up longer.
Of course, we'd be like, John, he never sells those trucks. Every 2 years, I get a new one just in case.
Just rotating.
No, but I notice stuff like that. Everybody else
he'll
does too.
Back
to
the front. Oh, rest in front. Well, he can come.
Well, I.
Tony, are you suggesting that?
Table until next month.
So come in for formal request of funds next month. Mm-hmm. There you go.
But do we want to do
we
that?
We may or may not know the total ice budget by then.
Do we want to do that though? Or do we want to defer it until 2016?
Well, that depends on what that is.
I think he just wants to know that we would approve it.
But it's for ordering purposes. If we order them now, we'll get them about the 1st of March. So there's about a 3 to 4 month delay over there. So we're trying to, if we wait, that was the issue with my Mary Brown. She came in like April, waited a little bit, and they stopped manufacturing in 2015. So now she has to wait until this bubble to get the 2016 today.
So if you have a verbal commitment from the council and commissioners, because they're the ones that actually purchase them, I think.
Right, yeah.
Then I think that would allow you to go ahead and put your name in the hat.
Because we wouldn't technically need the additional until February, March, April, you know, somewhere along there to pay for it.
Is that work for you?
That's what I was.
We've done that before. We've done that in the past. Sometimes you get the fleet price. Are you getting the fleet price?
We're getting, right, the Department Administration, the QPA is what we're going for.
So we need to make a motion?
No. Well, only that we're going to verbally give it. Yeah. $120,000
110. It's what would happen to it. We've got three vehicles that are right there at 100,000 miles. I'll tell you, I think the trucks will end up saving us money with the resale option. Those cars are worth it. I mean, you've got to lose your people in the neighborhood. Well, do we want to make a motion? No, you're good.
Okay.
I'd say, Commissioners,
just a little discussion, and I'll come back after the first year for the money.
We got appropriated after the first year anyways.
Thank you.
Things get off, you're not supposed to be standing up anyway.
Yeah.
Your doctor's not here.
That's right.
All right. Possible transfer thing, that's not. Is there any other county business we need to take care of? You said that's not happening.
I wouldn't. Which one did you press?
The possible transfer, that, yeah, there's, we have possible transfers here for.
No, he's gonna have to do an additional next month for that, for the Clay County Task Force.
Task Force.
Okay.
For investigation.
Okay.
Okay, so there is, but the deputy is an item.
Oh, request for additional deputy.
Right.
Thank God, you need to sit down, you don't need to stand.
I would like to request an additional deputy. The reason being, we had, Kate Baker was off 4 years, or 4 months this year. We've got 4 months of his salary that has not been used this year. Rob Gamble has been on workman's comp for approximately 5 months this year. And so, you know, that part of the salary has been saved also. I'd like to request an additional deputy for this next year and try to get him back into the budget again.
Because we have basically 9 months of salary built up.
That's right.
And actually, one of those is Rob. Well, I guess probably not. I don't know what for me.
I know you eliminated it last year.
Right.
I'm requesting to get it back in, so.
If we do that, will we have a full-time person in the courthouse again?
We're working to get a special deputy and get them in the courthouse as much as we can. And yes, you know, I will work to try to get one in here full-time.
I can assure you that would be one stipulation we'd want to make. You know, I understand, you know, when your staffing is like staffing situation is right now. But I've had several comments made, you know, there's, they want that person in here.
And we've responded from across the street on problems over here already several times. And, you know, I've been able to handle it like we did in the past. You know, it was nice to have someone over here, I'll be honest with you.
When we added the additional deputy last year specifically for the courthouse, and so that's one of the reasons why when we didn't replace the one deputy, came, and then the one was immediately gone from the courthouse, that wasn't necessarily very pleasing. So, and like I said, I understand your staffing issues, but if we were going to reinstate another deputy, I think that needs to be accomplished. That's my feelings. Anybody else have? So
now the $1 million question is, you know, we're probably okay for next year. That money came out of low public safety. We've got money going back in that'll fund 9 months of the year, and we can probably, our low public safety is probably okay to fund the other 3 months. Then in 2017, we're going to have to fund that position.
We'll just have to cross that bridge when we probably get there. And we might be able to do it for 2016.
I mean, I wouldn't have a problem, you know, if we have to at the time of budget. Saying, okay, we're going to fund this courthouse position out of ICE money. If the ICE program goes away, then we may or may not have to eliminate that position. That's just me.
John,
what do you guys think of that?
They also mentioned about using reserve debt this year, too.
You okay with that?
Well, about that.
Did Jamie hear what I said?
First come up.
Well, we're good for next year.
Right.
And what I said was I wouldn't have a problem at budget time next year if we need to do it, say, okay, we're going to fund the courthouse deputy out of ICE money.
Right.
And then if the ICE program goes away, we may or may not have to do something with that position. Hopefully it won't ever come to that.
Yeah.
I agree. What about doing, you know, there was discussion of doing reserve deputies or different things, and is there any more discussion of that?
I'm still looking at the special deputy. There again, you know, there'll be a part-time employee. One of the problems with that is hiring someone on a part-time basis. You know, at what the special deputy, you know, rate is, it's kind of hard to find someone that's willing to work for, what is that, for $10.90? I believe, $10.90 an hour. To find someone to work at that rate, less than 28 hours a week.
And to have the proper training and knowledge.
What about some retired? Is there anybody retired?
They're still, then they would still have to go through some of the training, being that they're retired, but I mean, that's kind of something we had discussed. That was why we presented in the budget, putting two people in there, kind of using that as a transition period, see that we need to work. Being able to get someone on a regular basis who's retired, but yet only work 28 hours, we don't know how that would work. So yeah, that was something we're trying to kind of get a feel for sure.
Well, we've got some time to think about it. If we do this, yeah, it buys us some time.
Well, as I can point out, we approved another $10,000 in the budget for a second person to be in there part time. So if you add that to the other figures, we're almost going to get through the year. So, next year at budget time, we'll just have to see where we're at for funding that position the following year.
Yeah. With, you know, Rob being off so far, did have an escrow the last time, and I understand that.
And Kate quitting.
So I don't foresee that you're going to have any issues with that.
But the reserves will all be trained and everything, right?
Yes, you know, the problem with the reserve is that we can't pay a reserve deputy, you have to be a special deputy. And then his duties would be strictly for the courthouse or whatever the sheriff would tell him at the time. So it's a tightrope we have to walk for that. But like I said, yes, I would like to do that. But there again,
if we had two bulk and one bigger reserve and one other special, would they both have to be special deputies?
Oh, I'm sorry.
With the bands, yes.
So we could amend that.
One of the things running through the reserves, ones that are trained, actually a lot more, quite a bit. Those guys aren't retired, so they have full-time jobs during the daytime.
We would just approve the salary.
So it gets tricky finding somebody to fit the criteria that has some of the training, but to be able to work during those times. Yeah. So that's where, you know, bringing up the retired aspect, that is something that we had talked about and contemplated. But then, you know, if you're retired, there's a lot of guys that want to stay retired and don't want to work. So there's, you know,
we've had a dose of seeing that deputy in there when we come to this courthouse. Now it sticks out like a sore thumb.
Well,
we're used to seeing it.
I'll tell you, and unfortunately, in today's society, it's sad that we have to think about having a deputy in here. But I can tell you, that deputy was extremely busy, and we probably could have used more than one, to be completely honest. But financially, it's hard to supplement that, you know, that expenditure. But with everything that's going on in today's society, it's hard to cut the law enforcement, especially the courthouse, because it's only knock on wood, you know, when, not if. So
you did make some arrests from that position to get them.
You make a lot of warrants.
You make 5 to 10 arrests in a week. I mean, I made 3 arrests in one day coming over here, and I wasn't specifically working in here. So
just off of warrants.
Not just what? No, it's even people. I mean, we had one incident in circuit court. Where it had a big blow up, the judge is called over, you know, needing help and arresting him on this contempt and disorderly conduct. And then we had another one where an individual walked out of court and punched the wall and started breaking stuff. So those are all situations that, you know.
Yeah.
Stuff happens. So it's definitely nice when people see the officer and see the presence. They're less likely to do it, but they still do.
Live in interesting times. Who was it that said maybe we live in interesting times? I think he messed up. Okay.
I think we should do a motion
Okay.
stating that using funds that were not spent in this fiscal year, plus additional money that we approve for next year.
She can add it to the salary.
She'll add it to our salary ordinance for 2016 that will allow them to add that deputy back in. And you're wanting to do it now because you're getting, going through the hiring process.
Motion by Mike?
Yes, motion.
Is there any discussion? Seeing none, proceed to vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, so if I got your motion right, we're using the money that wasn't spent, then we'll do a transfer for about $10,000 to put that back in the deputy line, and you'll have to do that in January, actually.
Right. We have to.
Yes.
We actually even have that additional appropriation since it wasn't in the budget.
Because of salary ordinance. Oh, I
even though the salary ordinance allows it.
Yeah.
Where's that in the budget? Is it in personal services? It's in personal services already.
Well, that's true.
So I don't think
the money's going to be there, so the problem is not there.
No, I think you're okay there.
Yeah.
The $25,000.
Yeah.
All right. Anybody else have any business bring forward to council?
I just need all of you to follow me in there so we can get this document for y'all to sign it.
You got to get some stuff backed up to be able to get it.
Commissioners have anything?
Commissioners?
When are you getting your new fence?
They started today.
Did they?
Yes.
Jim Bowman, new commissioner, got anything going on? He's still in learning mode.
Yeah, let's do that.
Brian?
Hopefully we got asphalt and get ready to start getting laid. So.
Saw the asphalt machine. Paul? All right. Is there a motion to adjourn? Moved by Jason.
Second
by Pat. Any discussion? Seeing none, proceed to vote. All in favor of leave. All opposed, say aye. Public hearing.